Good morning, everyone. I'm glad to be here this morning. I'm Dr. Brown Johnson, and I'm part of the whole health team here at the Atlanta VA. And myself and Ms. Angela Jackson, who's a registered nutritionist and dietitian, will be presenting to you on whole health here at the Atlanta VA. We also want to mention Dr. Phyllis Rutledge, who helped with this presentation today, even though she's not able to be with us. So we want to talk a little bit about whole health here in Atlanta at the VA and tell you a little bit about some of the special programs that we have within whole health. Today we're going to be focusing on mindfulness and also on inflammation and nutrition. So what is whole health? I know you've heard this word. It's becoming a catch-all phrase, certainly here at the VA. We want to make sure that you understand what we're talking about when we say whole health. Whole health embraces what we traditionally know of as medical care, what we consider Western traditional medicine, along with the complementary and sometimes called integrative medicine techniques that are sometimes considered maybe non-traditional. Some of them come out of the Eastern tradition. It also embraces the self-healing mechanisms that are within all of us. And the wonderful thing about whole health is that whether you're looking at the Western traditional part of it, the complementary medicine part, or the self-healing mechanisms, there's plenty of good research that supports all of it. Whole health also puts you as the patient at the center of your health care. It looks at the importance of what's important to you, what are your goals, what are your traditions, what does your culture embrace and support, and brings those things at the center of your care, allowing those things to help really direct and help us focus as we partner with you on your health care journey. Lastly, in terms of whole health, I just want to mention that whole health really allows you and has allowed the VA as a whole, and this is a national movement here at the VA that comes from the Office of Patient-Centered Care, in which the VA is really shifting its focus from a very diseased-focused type of care to a wellness type of care, in which we're changing the question from what's the matter with you to what matters to you. And we're encouraging all veterans to come to the whole health introduction class and spend the time in some self-reflection, in some learning, completing what's called the personal health inventory, which will really help you look at your life in a very holistic way and help to develop a personal health plan. So this is a little bit about our mission here in Atlanta, that we want to help all of you reach your self-determined health goals, that we want to, as I mentioned earlier, help to shift the conversation from a disease focus to a wellness focus, and we really hope to reach all of the veterans here at the Atlanta VA. This is our circle of health, and as you look at this, you'll see that around the circle, you're going to see eight very important aspects of your life, and these are sort of the building blocks of whole health as it's been developed by the Office of Patient-Centered Care of the National VA office. But one thing I want you to notice is the center of the circle. And in the center of the circle, you'll see you. And that's because you are the most important thing about your healthcare journey. We cannot neglect, we cannot overlook the things that are most important to you as we lead you and direct your healthcare journey. So it has to rise up out of the things that are most important to you. And our whole health program in Atlanta looks at these eight areas around the circle and helps you to focus in on developing your health, your life, in each of those eight areas. A little bit about our classes here in Atlanta. Right now we have over 15 different classes in multiple locations. We have, as I mentioned, the whole health introduction class, which is the class that you should start with, and that's a two-hour class that's available both at Fort Mac, here at the Atlanta VA Medical Center, and also at the Atlanta or Arcadia Clinic in Decatur. We also have whole health support groups that can support you after you finish the whole health introduction. Then we have several food groups, food as medicine, and Ms. Jackson, our registered nutritionist and dietitian, will be talking about that a little bit later. Then we have several classes. Let me not forget the cooking class. We also have several classes that support just personal development and the power of the mind, mindfulness, which is what we'll be talking about today. And then we have classes that are helping you in other aspects of your life, such as spirituality and relationships. So let's shift our gears, and we want to focus on what is mindfulness. Mindfulness is a buzzword that you hear a lot about now in the media and everywhere. You'll hear about it in sports. They have sports psychologists who talk about helping athletes to really get in the zone by helping them to learn mindfulness techniques. And it's really just about being aware of the moment, being aware of your surroundings, of your thoughts, your feelings, and how you are right in the moment, instead of the way many of us are, where we're sort of in one place, but our mind is in another, or sometimes our mind is in many other places. And this whole mindfulness movement here in the United States, it springs out of a Buddhist tradition, but here in the States, it was really transformed into a non-religious type of movement, which was developed by Jon Kabat-Zinn. He's a professor at the University of Massachusetts, and he developed it and has developed courses called mindfulness-based stress reduction, which can help you learn mindfulness techniques and how to live your life in a more mindful way. And I'm happy to say that we have mindfulness courses here at the Atlanta VA. A little bit more about mindfulness. How does it help us? Why is it important? Is this just a fad? Why should you be interested in taking a course in mindfulness? Well, as I mentioned, there's been research on a lot of complementary techniques, and in mindfulness, there has been research in mindfulness as well, and teaching them how to do mindfulness meditation. And they compared that to some of our more traditional treatment approaches to low back pain and found that both worked equally as well. So again, in practicing mindfulness, it will improve your quality of life. It will help you to understand clearly. And when we say that it helps you to see clearly, we're not really talking about vision there, but what we're really talking about is that it helps you to reflect and understand your emotions and what's going on with your life more clearly. One thing that I would encourage you to do is to, if you have the smartphone that many of us carry around in our pocket, these little computers that we carry around, to learn a little bit more about mindfulness, there are several apps that you might want to download on the smartphone that could help you learn about mindfulness. One is actually put out by the VA, and that's called the Mindfulness Coach app. So look for that in your app store on your telephone. And another one is a great app called Calm, C-A-L-M, a beautiful app that also will teach you and take you through some mindfulness meditation sessions, and also has something that I love called sleep stories on it. They'll read you a story to help you go to sleep. Also, we remember we talked about mindfulness as a way to improve compassion. And when we think about compassion, we think about not only compassion for others, but what some of us often forget is the compassion that we need for ourselves. So we're hoping to get more veterans involved with mindfulness and have it become a way of life here at the Atlanta VA. I want to just end with a loving kindness meditation. And I don't know where you are at this moment when you're as you're watching this Facebook Live presentation, but let me just invite you to just sit very comfortably in the chair that you're in. Sit back, put your back on the back of the chair, put your feet flat on the ground if you're in the chair. And I want you to just, if you're comfortable, close your eyes. And I want you to take some nice deep breaths. Some of the things that we teach in mindfulness are the importance of breath and how if we focus on our breathing, which is something we take for granted, that it can really take us to a place of relaxation. And so as you focus on your breath, what I want you to do is not what most of us do all the time, which is just take these little shallow breaths where we don't breathe into our stomach, because I guess we want to hold it in. But I want you to just let it out. So take a nice deep breath all the way into the belly. And don't worry about it sticking out. And then as you're breathing out, I just want you to breathe way out deeply. And one thing that can be very helpful is as you're breathing in and breathe out, just notice the timing. And if you can breathe in to about 5 or 6 breath counts and then breathe out to about 7 or 8 counts, what that does is it actually slows down your sympathetic nervous system. It just helps you to calm and relax. And if you'll take a few breaths like that, those nice deep belly breaths in, then I want you, if you can, and if you feel comfortable, to close your eyes. And we're just going to repeat a little bit of this loving kindness meditation. And so I'll say it, and if you want to say it aloud, or if you just want to say it quietly, internally to yourself, that's fine. But just focus on the breathing. May I be well. May I be peaceful. May I be safe and protected. May I be happy and healthy. And generally what we would do if we were going to do this whole meditation is we would have you focus on doing this and focus not only on yourself, but then repeat these phrases again and focus on someone that you hold dear to yourself. So I leave you with that, and hopefully maybe you'll do a little bit of mindfulness on your own after this Facebook Live presentation. But now I want to turn it over to Miss Angela Jackson, and she's a registered dietitian and nutritionist here in Atlanta, and she's going to be talking with you about inflammation.
Thank you, Dr. Brown Johnson. My name is Angela Jackson. I'm one of the clinical dietitians at the Atlanta VA Medical Center, and I'm happy that you've joined us this morning to learn more about whole health. Today, I'm going to speak with you about inflammation and how nutrition can affect what's going on in our body. So you may ask, what is inflammation? It is the body's response to injury and its attempt to heal itself. There are two types of inflammation, acute and chronic. Acute inflammation occurs when we have, for an example, a cut. It's short term, and it is characterized by pain, redness, immobility, pain, and heat. Chronic inflammation, however, is not so obvious. It is long term and systemic. It is characterized by fatigue, fever, rash, joint pain, chest pain, and abdominal pain, just to name a few. We are fully aware that our diet that we consume can inflame our body. This is known as the standard American diet, the SAD diet. It is full of foods that are fried, processed meats such as hot dogs and luncheon meats, processed cheeses on our cheeseburgers and pizzas, fried chicken, French fries, foods that have dyes, such as sodas, Coca-Colas, and cereals, as well as refined carbohydrates, such as the pastries and potato chips that we often snack on. Also, please note that our lifestyle can also inflame us as well. So if you are consuming an excessive amount of alcohol, smoking, or sitting for long periods of time with very little to no physical activity dedicated most days of the week, your body is going to be inflamed. However, there's hope. There are a lot of foods that will combat inflammation. As you see here, such things as tomatoes, green peppers, bell peppers, cruciferous vegetables, such as broccoli and cauliflower. The Mediterranean diet is well known and well researched and often recommended. It is full of leafy green vegetables such as kale, collards, spinach. However, if you are on Coumadin, please check with your dietitian or your pharmacist because you may have to adjust the amount of the leafy green vegetables you may take in. As well as healthy fats such as almonds and walnuts, fatty fishes such as salmon, mackerel, tuna, sardines, olive oil as well, lots of berries. It's also limited in poultry and low-fat dairy. Usually you'll have those about 2 servings out of the week. And red meat is also limited in the Mediterranean diet. But as you can see, it's a lot of food. You will be full. Also, our lifestyle can combat inflammation as well. Making sure you're getting plenty of water, plain water that is, nothing that you're adding to the water for flavor. So the gold standard is 64 ounces of water, also 2 liters or 4 bottles of water a day. However, the amount will adjust based on your gender, your physical activity, your environment, and any medical conditions you have. So make sure you speak with your dietitian about how much water is recommended for you. And physical activity. Again, please contact your medical doctor to see the amount and frequency and the best types of exercise for you. But it is recommended at least 150 minutes of dedicated exercise a week, as simple as walking. This is a list of foods that is included in our anti-inflammatory diet. A lot of them I've already mentioned, and I'll give you an opportunity to kind of look over that as well. It is very comprehensive. It's telling you some things to eat more of, as I've mentioned before, and some foods that you want to avoid eating. But please note, please consult with your medical doctor and or your pharmacist if you are currently taking or planning to take any herbs, as they may not be healthy for you and can possibly interact with the medications you take or exacerbate your current medical condition. This is a diagram of a healthy plate. You see, half of the plate is fruits and vegetables, particularly your non-starchy vegetables, as I mentioned earlier. A quarter of your plate is going to be your whole grains, such as whole wheat bread, quinoa, and brown rice, and it's a little sweet potato. And the other quarter of your plate is going to be your healthy, lean proteins, beans and lentils, poultry, particularly the poultry breast, and those fatty fishes that I mentioned earlier. It's no coincidence that four of the letters in health are heal. And remember, those who think they have no time for healthy eating will sooner or later have to find time for illness. Please join us for our food as medicine classes. They are offered in 3 locations at the Atlanta VA Medical Center on Claremont Road, the second Wednesday of the month from 9 to 11 a.m. in the Gathering Place, as well as the Atlanta VA Clinic located on North Arcadia Avenue in the Women's Wellness Area on the first and third Thursday of the month from 1 to 2 p.m. and Fort McPherson VA Clinic located at 1701 Hardy Avenue the first and second Tuesday from 10 to 11 a.m. We also have a Cooking for Wellness class. It is offered also at the Atlanta VA Clinic located on North Arcadia Avenue on the second Thursdays from 3 to 4 p.m. And we're just going to teach you how to put together some foods quickly, but they're healthy. So you don't have to reinvent the wheel. We have that information for you. Please join us. Remember, whole health for life. We are here for you. We are changing the conversation from what is the matter to what matters to you. And now I'd like to ask Dr. Brown Johnson to please come back and join me, just in case we have any questions for you out there in Facebook Live land. We'll be glad to address those questions that you may have.
First question. I suffer from PTSD. Will whole health help me eliminate PTSD?
So that's a great question. And actually, a lot of the modalities in whole health are directed at PTSD. And remember, whole health springs right out of the VA, so they're very well aware of the need for veterans to access things that will help with PTSD. Today we talked about mindfulness, which there's been research showing that learning that mindfulness techniques and being involved in mindfulness meditation can be helpful for PTSD. Of course, improving your diet and having a diet that's anti-inflammatory helps your entire health, so it can help with that as well. We have several other classes, though, that can help with PTSD. One of them that I'd like to mention is yoga. And there has been research showing that yoga, and particularly we have trauma-sensitive yoga. So we have a yoga instructor that has been trained to help people with all kinds of physical and mental health problems, to use yoga to help access healing, the self-healing mechanisms that we talked about. So yes, Whole Health for Life, we have things that can help with PTSD. And we welcome you and hope that you'll come and join us.
Next question. There's a lot of discussion in the news about the opioid crisis across the VA. Is Whole Health the answer to this crisis?
Wow, the answer to the crisis. Whole Health is part of the answer to the crisis. And of course, you know, healthcare across the country, and certainly healthcare, all aspects of healthcare at the VA are coming together to address the opioid crisis. And with the chronic pain that often is at the root of the opioid use for many of our veterans, many of our classes are geared towards helping people to really assess their chronic pain and develop tools that will help them to deal with it. As part of Whole Health for Life, we here in Atlanta have a very special program called the Empower Veterans Program. And that is for veterans that have severe chronic pain. And that is actually a 10-week program, which is devoted towards helping you to address your pain, to learn about pain, and to learn things that can help you to cope with your pain in a better way so that you can have a better life. Also, many of our whole health classes can help with this as well. And again, I bring up mindfulness because there has been research showing that mindfulness can definitely help with pain, as I mentioned earlier in the presentation, and also the yoga class. Again, yoga is one of those things that can help with chronic pain. And I would not want to leave out inflammation, so I want you to just mention a little bit about that in terms of chronic pain.
So we do know that inflammation, again, can lead to chronic illnesses and chronic pain. So we want to help you all to change your dietary intake. When you get less of the added sugars and added sodium that can also exacerbate your diabetes or high blood pressure, even kidney failure, this is going to lead to pain as well. So come join us so we can teach you and give you all the tools that you need to make healthy lifestyle changes, and that includes your diet as well. And again, the goal is to help you to reduce that chronic pain, decrease, or even completely come off of those opioids that we are hearing so much about in the news.
Do the satellite clinics offer whole health?
And as Ms. Jackson mentioned in her presentation, currently most of our classes are available at three locations, and that is here at the Medical Center, at the main VA campus, also at the Arcadia Clinic or the Atlanta VA Clinic, and then at Fort Mac. In the next year, our whole health classes will be branching out, and so there will be more availability at some of the other community-based clinics.
One particular veteran wants to know, I live in Rome, so would I have to travel to the VA in Decatur to take advantage of this program?
And we are very aware of the need to get this information and the classes and these modalities out. So our plan for the upcoming year, as I mentioned, is that we will be branching out, but also that we'll be using telehealth techniques. We've got to use our technology to reach our veterans that are not as close to the main medical center. So there will be classes closer to you, but there will also be availability of these classes to on telehealth techniques. So look for that. We'll be getting that information out to you.
Any final comments?
It's been a pleasure to talk with you all today about Whole Health for Life. We are very excited about this program. Nationally, it's very exciting to see the VA moving in this direction. This is going to change the focus of healthcare at the VA, and it's really a movement that's coming in healthcare in the country. So we're excited that the VA is at the forefront of this change as we change the conversation, as we put you at the center, as we use all of the many health modalities and recognize the importance of self-healing. We invite you to come and join us. come to our Whole Health for Life classes. We invite you to start with Whole Health Introduction, which is a class that will help you to really evaluate where you are. And I notice that we don't have our phone number up on the screen, but you can contact anyone in your primary care clinic, and they have all of the information. They can also put in a consult that can get you to Whole Health, and they can also give you a number that can allow you to call and make appointments as well. So thank you for being with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you.